Lee Newman, who became the dean of IE Business School in June 2021, stated, "We're going to ask students to install all of these tools, Midjourney, DALL-E, and ChatGPT, and then begin to use them to do their work. Many schools are doing the opposite." He further emphasized, "Our belief is that we need to quickly incorporate intelligent machines and tools, such as AI, as part of the student's toolbox." During the South Summit Madrid 2023, startup event held at La Nave Convention Center in Madrid, Spain, on the 8th local time, Maeil Business Newspaper interviewed Lee Newman, Dean of IE Business School, to discuss his thoughts on the era of Industry 5.0 and ChatGPT. One of the topics discussed at the South Summit Madrid 2023 was Industry 5.0. How do you define Industry 5.0?
Well, if we think about 4.0, these change all the time. I mean, 4.0 was largely about connecting machines to machines. So how do I connect my machine to your machines? Mm-hmm. How do I connect my factory to your suppliers, to those suppliers, to their suppliers?
Yes.
How do I, connectivity between customers, producers, suppliers, etc. Right? So very much machine. So with industrial, within, you know, 5.0, Industry 5.0, now it's about machine and human, right? So that's a big change, right? So let's now that we've got everything connected, which worked quite well, what's this for? I mean, who is this for? I mean, there's efficiency to be gained from a process automation standpoint, right, from 4.0. But I think the next step here with 5.0 is how do we now make sure that all of these connected machines and devices are not only intelligent, but are useful to us, that help us solve the problems that we need to solve as humans, that enable us to do our work better. So it's a machine to human and human to machine, set of objectives now. And I think it goes in both directions, right? So part of it is, how do we design the machines, the algorithms, the bots, so that they are useful to us? So humans, factors, design, human centricity, in the design of these machines. But it also, you can flip it around and ask, well, how can we work with those machines in a way that helps them? Because at the end of the day, we choose right now what we train these intelligent machines. We're choosing the training sets.
Yes.
We're choosing many, many things. And these machines need feedback, the same way we need feedback, right? I mean, AI learns. It's a learning, the basis of intelligence is learning.
Do you believe that the rise of technologies such as robots and artificial intelligence has influenced people's sense of purpose?
The last one I'll mention is this increasing concern by younger generations with the idea of purpose and meaning and values. You know, companies are really having to articulate their own purpose, what they stand for, to attract and retain talent. I think it's enhanced, or depending on whether you like the purpose movement, I mean, enhanced or exacerbated. But I would say enhanced. I mean, I think, you know, not only is there now this kind of this deeply rooted sense of purpose and meaning that younger business professionals are in search of, but now you say, well, okay, but how is this going to work with AI and bots and robots and so forth? So I think the rise of technology is creating more questions about purpose and meaning, but in a good way, and I think it also aligns with it in the sense that, I mean, if AI takes away the least interesting, the least exciting parts of our jobs, I think we're all happy. So everybody's talking about the dangers and the risks of AI, which are real and important. But on the positive side, I mean, we're already, just from ChatGPT, we're already getting huge boosts in our productivity, right? And so as that happens, I think that opens the door to an increase in the opportunity to obtain a sense of purpose at work.
One of the current topics in the education industry is the concept of a virtual teacher. Realistically, do you think virtual teachers can be realized?
Very.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I mean, I can't say too much, but I can say that we are working quickly to on a concept that you might call the augmented professor. So, I mean, some people are talking about, well, we're going to replace professors. I mean, let's see what the 10 years is very hard to predict. But what we're working on is the augmented professor. So how can we put in the hands of of program management in the hands of students and in the hands of professors, tools that deepen learning and make make the delivery of education more efficient. So, so for the moment, what we're focused on is tools that augment the ability of the professor to interact more with students. So the idea is to how can we give students more feedback, better feedback, and how can we free up the professors to engage with students at a higher level? Right now, one of the barriers is time. I mean, how much time can a professor spend engaging with students at the deepest level, right? So if we can have machines take over part of the interactive process that's lower value, but it's valuable for students, but it's less of a value added from the standpoint of the professor, fantastic. So that's what we're doing. I would say it started, you know, a couple months ago when ChatGPT started.